see, the vector control operation of permeable magnet synchronous motor drive, which is algorithm is developed by National Infotech. So basically, we are controlling ID and IQ current using some mathematics. For your reference, we'll see the block diagram. You can pause the video and you can take a close look of this block diagram. We are using this block diagram only. This is a simple block diagram of field oriented control. And one to one, we have implemented this block diagram in coding using Wizone. So we are achieving the field oriented control using this. So we have to provide 300 volt DC link for this case. Here you can see the voltmeter showing 300 volt. I have given the 300 volt using the variac, and we will measure the one phase current. The current meter is also connected. We have basic UI over here, so you can see. We have shown the D quantity, which is the current quantity, ID. Q quantity, which is also current quantity, which is quadrature axis current, Q, IQ, and on off status of the drive, reference speed and measure speed. All other quantities you can see on the DAC. We have 15 different selection for the vector control. You can see 15 of any quantity on the DAC. So basically, what we will do sequentially is we will give the DC voltage to our inverter using variac, and we will give accurately 300 volt to our DC link, and we will reset the controller before starting the drive. As we will reset the controller, the motor will set at its zero position. As you can see, right now it is at its zero position. If I will change the position and I will reset the controller, it will again gain its zero position. So this is its zero position. That is very important for the permanent magnet motor drive. So we have given the zero position, then we are good to start. So now we will press the start button. So initially, motor will rotate on 500 RPM. So you can see right now motor is rotating at 500 RPM. We can vary the speed using the enter key. So we have different speed command on the ADC of the controller. So we can vary from 500 to 3000 RPM. So we will see one step of that. So I will change the speed. Let's say something around 1000 RPM. So we have set around 1350 RPM. Speed is around 1350 RPM, and I will increase the load. In the case of vector control, we will increase the load on the motor, and we will see. First, you can take the observation of no load. You can see the D current is zero, is around zero, and Q current is around 0.5. As I will increase the load, Q current should increase only, D current should not increase. So you can see over here, only Q current, value of Q current is increasing. And we have around 1 ampere of magnitude. So you can see what we are doing over here is, So this is our current. This is IA. This is IB. IC. All three currents. Then this is theta, the angle of the encoder, which we are getting from the encoder. Then we have ID and IQ. So here you are, this is our ID, which is around to zero, and blue line is our IQ. So as I will decrease the load, the value of IQ will decrease. As I will increase the load, the value of IQ will increase. So you can see there is no effect of load on the ID, because ID is our flux component and IQ is our torque component. So as we will change the torque, that should not be any effect on ID component. So this is one thing you can show as a proof of vector control. Then we are changing the signals using two pins. So then we have V alpha and V beta. So this is the waveforms. Firstly, we have three currents and the theta. Then we will convert it into ID and IQ. Then we will apply some PI parameter. We will get VD and VQ using those PI, and we will determine V alpha and V beta. So that determined V alpha and V beta is showing right now. Then we can see the sector in which the SVM is going. So this is a vector control is also happening using the SVM. So this is our VA and VB, VB and VC. So we have three waveforms of VA, VB and VC. Then we have set speed and actual speed. So as you can see, as I will increase the load, speed will fluctuate and it will again track the set speed. So we have, as I said, we have 15 different quantities. Again, we are at the current. So we have total 15 different quantities to show on the DAC of the controller. This is the list of the quantities which we are taking. This is a second code. So this is the list of the quantity that we are taking on the DAC. All quantities we can see on the deck. So that was all for vector control. And we will see in the sensorless control in the next video.